in spite of the Caribbean, by providence impoverished and squalor, grow up to be a hero and a scholar.
The $10 founding father without a father, got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter. By 14, they placed him in charge of the trading shop.
Every day while slaves were being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside, he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter.
Then a hurricane came and devastation rained our land. Saw his future dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain. And wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain.
We got around and they said, this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came. And the world is gonna know your name. What's your name, man?
Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things I haven't done, but just you wait, just you.
Cousin committed suicide, left him with nothing but brewing pride. Something new inside a boy saying,
Alex, you gotta fend for yourself.
He started retreating and leaving every tree to storm a shell. There would have been nothing left to do for someone less astute. He would have been dead or destitute without a sense of restitution. Started working, clerking for his late mother's landlord. Spending sugar cane and rum and all the things he can't afford. Scamming for every book he can get his hands on. Planning for the future, see him now as he stands on the bow of a ship, headed for a new land. In New York, you can be a new man.
In New York, you can be a new man. In New York, you can be a new man. In New York, you can be a new man.
Less.
What?
Smile more. Thank you. When's he gonna get me? In my sleep, 7 feet ahead of me? If I see it coming, do I run or do I let it be? Is it like a beat without a melody? See, I never thought I'd live past 20. Where I come from, some get half as many. Ask anybody why we're living fast, and we laugh, reach for our flask. We have to make this moment last, and that's plenty. Scratch that, this is not a moment, it's the movement. We're all the hungriest, but this was something to prove. When those opposers, we take an honest stand. We go like Moses, claiming our promised land. Damn, if we win our independence, let it guarantee a freedom for our descendants. But with the blood we shed, begin an endless cycle of vengeance and death with no descendants. And all the action in the street is excited with Jesus. Between all the pleading and fighting, I've been reading and writing. We need to handle our financial situation. Are we a nation of states? What's the state of our nation? I'm past patiently waiting, I'm passionate.
Thank you. trust me.
If you have really common sense about Thomas Paine, somebody say that I'm a tank, so I'm a saint. You want a revolution, I want a revelation. So listen to my declaration. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. And when I'm becoming represented, I'm a companion to his own women in the sequel. What?
But
any hope of success is fleeting. How can I keep bleeding when the people I'm leading keep retreating? We put a stop to the bleeding as the British take Brooklyn. Night takes Rook, but look, we are outgunned.
What?
Outmanned.
What?
Outnumbered. Outplanned. We gotta make an all out stand. Ain't no one gonna need a right hand man. I think that I could be of some assistance. I admire how you keep firing on the British from a distance. I have some questions, a couple of suggestions on how to fight instead of fleeing west.
Yes.
What?
Your Excellency, you wanted to see me.
Hamilton, come in. Have you met Barbara?
Yes, sir.
We keep meeting. As I was saying, sir, I look forward to seeing your strategy play out.
Burr, sir, close the door on your way out. Have I done something wrong, sir?
On the contrary. I called you here because our odds are beyond scary. Your reputation precedes you, but I have to laugh.
Sir?
Hamilton, how come no one can get you on their staff?
Sir?
Don't get me wrong. You're a young man of great renown. I knew you killed British cannons when we were still downtown. Nathaniel Greene and Henry Knox wanted to hire you
to be their secretary. I don't think so.
Now, why are you upset?
I'm not.
It's all right you want to fight. You got a hunger. I was just like you when I was younger. Head full of fantasies of dying like a martyr.
Yes.
Dying is easy, young man. Living is harder.
Why are you telling me this?
I'm being honest. I'm working with a third of what our Congress has promised. We are a powder keg about to explode. I need someone like you to light the load.
So?
Son, we are outgunned, outmanned.
I need all the help you can get. I have some friends, Lawrence Funnigan, Juanita Lafayette, okay, whatever.
Outnumbered, outplanned.
I need some spies on the inside, some kingsmen who might let some things slide. I'll write to Congress and tell them we need supplies. We rally the guys, rest of the element of surprise. I'll write to fuck my station, organize with information. To be rise to the occasion of our new nation.
I do. Hey! to meet you.
Skylar.
My sister. Thank you for all your service.
If it takes fighting a war for us to meet, it will have been worth it.
I'll leave you too.
1 week later.
Yeah.
fighting a war for us to meet. It will not be murder.
I'll leave you to it.
Number three.
I know my sister like I know my own.
Trying to keep the colonies alive.
Hamilton doesn't hesitate. He exhibits no restraint. He takes and he takes and he takes, and he keeps winning anyway. He changes the game. He plays and he raises the stakes. And if there's a reason, he seems to thrive when so few survive. And goddammit, I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it. Life is a discrimination.
Negotiate a people, negotiate a time and place. This is commonplace, especially to church.
Sure, but your man has to answer for his words, bro.
With his life? We both know that's absurd, sir.
Hang on, how many men died because Lee was inexperienced and ruinous?
Okay, so we're doing this.
Number 9!
Look him in the eye, ain't no higher. Summon all the courage you require. Then count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Number
10, place is right.
Lee, do you yield?
You shot him in the side, yes, he yields.
I'm satisfied.
So we gotta clear the field.
Go, we want
him. Here comes the general.
What is the meaning of this? Mr. Burke, get a medic for the general.
Yes, sir.
Lee, you will never agree with me, but believe me, these young men don't speak for me. Thank you for your service.
Let's ride.
Hamilton, sir,
meet me inside.
Enough without infight.
We called you out. We called you
up. You saw nothing. You aggravate our allies to the south.
You're absolutely right. John should have shot him in the mouth. That would have shut him up. Son. I'm not your son.
Watch your tone. I am not a maiden in need of defending. I am
Lee, Thomas Conway. These men take your name and they break it through the mud.
My name's been through a lot. I can take
well,
it.
Well, I don't have your name. I don't have your titles. I don't have your land.
But if you know,
if you gave me command of a battalion, a group of men to lead, I could fly above my station after the war.
Or you can die, and we need you alive.
I am more than willing to die.
Your wife needs you alive. Son, I need you alive.
All right, son, one more time.
Go home, Alexander. That's an order from your commander, sir.
Go home!
Unable to provide for your life.
a global superpower. How do we emerge victorious from the quagmire? Leave the battlefield waving Betsy Ross's flag higher. Yo, turns out we have a secret weapon in immigrants. You know a love who's unafraid to step in. He's constantly confusing, confounding the British handstand. Everyone give it up for America's favorite fighting Frenchman.
Shot. He was the never be free until we end slavery. And when we finally got the British away, Lafayette is there waiting in Chesapeake Bay. How did we know that this man would work? We had a spy on the inside, that's right.
I believe Solidarity! I'm a spy on the British government. I take the measure of information for my smuggling. Up to my brothers, revolutionary government. I'm running with the populace, see, I'm traveling. See, that's what happens when you lock against the properly. And clear the shit off, somebody gotta stop it. I believe Solidarity, I don't know what you got to do.
You have Corruption's such an old song that we can sing along in harmony, and nowhere is it stronger than in Albany. This colony's a
can we confirm?
Sir, this is a legal matter.
Yes, it is important to me.
What do you need?
Burr, you're a better lawyer than me.
Oh.
I know, I talk too much. I'm abrasive. You're incredibly important. You're succinct, persuasive. My client is a strong defense. You're the solution.
Who's your client?
New U.S. Constitution.
No.
Hear me out!
Wait!
A series of essays anonymously published defending the document to the public.
No one will read it.
I disagree.
And if it fails?
That's why we need it. The Constitution's a mess.
So it needs amendment.
It's full of contradictions.
So with independence, we have to start somewhere.
No.
No way.
You're making a mistake.
At night.
Hey! What are you waiting for? What are you stalled for?
What?
We won the war. What was it all for?
Do you support this Constitution?
Of course.
And what if you're backing the wrong force?
First, we studied and we fought and we killed for the notion of a nation. We now get to build. For once in your life, take a stand with pride.
I don't understand how you stand to the side.
Entitled The Federalist Papers. The plan was to write a total of 25 essays, the work divided evenly among the three men. In the end, they wrote 85 essays in a span of 6 months. John Jay got sick after writing 5. James Madison wrote 29. Hamilton wrote the other 51! How do you write like you're running out of time?
Just you wait.